What is going on, everyone? Welcome to another video from Featured Tech. In this video, I'm going to be discussing why I am returning my AirPods Max. Let's get started. So a little bit of a background. I was actually very excited to get these headphones and I had no intention of returning them because I thought they look really nice and I thought it's going to surpass everything I'm imagining for the headphones, and I was excited to get them and keep them. But throughout the few weeks that I've owned them, it kind of lost its magic on me, and let me explain why. First, after using it for really the first week, I came to the realization it's not worth $550. I actually paid close to $600 because of my state's tax. So it was really about $586 or $587 for these headphones. So after a week of using them, I noticed that it really doesn't justify the price point that I paid for it. They are impressive, but they're not $600 impressive. So the first reason is price. The other reason is battery life. The battery life didn't really impress me. At 20 hours with active noise cancellation turned on, it really wasn't that competitive to the market. Also, with the price point that, again, it was offering. I will be talking about price point a lot. I'm sorry, guys, but really, $600 for this headphone, it should have been incredible. And to some, it is, but to somebody like me, it really didn't meet that, you know, it didn't really meet that bar of super, super worth it headphones for me to pay that much for them. So like I already mentioned with the battery life, it really isn't much better than, let's just say, a Beats Solo Pro, which is out on the market right now for $180 or $200, I believe. So correct me in the comment section below how cheap you found the Beats Solo Pros. But the battery life is not that much impressive than the Beats Solo Pros. In fact, I think it's actually the same. Another thing I want to touch up on is the fact that these headphones, in my opinion, are not loud. So when I turn them up to max volume, they really aren't that loud, to me at least. Again, this is an opinion thing. You might think, you know, they're perfect for you, but to me, they weren't that loud. So that was very disappointing, you know, really after using it for a week. I tried it in all different platforms of audio. I tried using it on Spotify, maybe because I thought the different platforms would maybe enhance or be better with the music, but nothing helped. I tried using it on Spotify, Apple Music, YouTube, official purchase songs even. Nothing helped. So it's something with the headphones themselves. Maybe it's just not as powerful as far as volume like I thought it would be. So that was another disappointing factor with it. The final reason I'm returning these headphones, and this really makes up for about 10 to 15% of the reason why I'm returning these headphones, is because there's been reports out there of condensation forming within the ear cup. So let me show you what I mean by that. So apparently there has been reports that upon people using it for an hour and a half, really nothing more than that, condensation forms inside the ear cup. So right here, condensation forms. And when it forms, that water drops down in these holes and enters and possibly damages the sound driver. So this issue that was reported, it was actually by somebody on Twitter, and I wasn't impressed by Apple's reaction and Apple's response to it. They didn't jump right on it. It was actually multiple people that experienced this issue. It's not thousands, but it also isn't, you know, 5 or 10. So Apple's response wasn't the best, in my opinion. I didn't, you know, appreciate how slowly they responded. And based on, again, how expensive these headphones are, I don't want to deal with that. Even if they do offer a 1-year warranty, what's going to happen after the 1 year if this happens again? So, you know, would I be out of luck? if this happens after a year and one day, and this happens and Apple can't fix it, what am I supposed to do? So based on me taking a look at all these different factors that I mentioned in this video, I just didn't feel that it justifies the price point, and that's why I'm planning to return it. So this was my video on why I'm planning to return the Apple AirPods Max. If you did enjoy the video, make sure to like and subscribe. And if you have any questions or if you have any other suggestions on why you would return them, or if I'm making a mistake, leave them down in the comment section below. Hope you have a great day. Take care.